Mark is going up to fire station, I think he's picking up Kevin in a week, I know he's coming.
Brent, do you know everybody at the table?
Yeah, I just met George.
This is Jim.
Brent and I have, huh?
Yeah.
Bill Irving.
Resolution.
Bill's been on the budget committee for years.
Too long.
We all feel that way.
You're also on our space needs committee and our highway safety.
Yes.
Which we don't have to meet too often, we don't, we have one coming.
Yeah, we have.
He's gonna pull it on our list.
George, it's on this list. It's all your fault, Brent.
Of course, yeah, gotta blame somebody, might as well take blame me. A couple of issues I think they should be looked at.
Yeah, I agree, we talked to the chief and told him about it, so. I do have thoughts. When he passed out, I'll finally come talk about it.
Denise, if there's any extra copies afterwards, may I have one?
Yes, there's extra, how many did you make, madame?
There are six.
Six total?
I think there are six total, we have one, two, three, four, five. Well, I have two here, so we'll see who comes.
That's why I said if there was any left.
Yeah, there is, absolutely. I think it's online too, isn't it? Is it in the cell? I think it's on the drive, maybe not?
It could be, we can check.
All right, we'll call you to order at 6:30, and we can start off with the government administration. In the event that we stay here versus building a new facility, we would have to have pretty soon a new town hall boiler and a roof in 2024. The other thing is Old Mill Lane Bridge. Do you know more about that than you know, do, Caroline?
So Old Mill Lane has a bridge which failed state inspection. The state inspects bridges every year and comes up with a listed bridge list, and that was on the list, and then one day the state says thou shalt not pass. And so this was probably, you know, close to 10 years ago by now.
Yeah, it's been quite a while.
We put a temporary structure over it. That has a lifespan, I think, of 20 years or 30 years or something. It's obviously not indefinite. So there's questions about what to do with that, but we got a plan to do something with it.
You know what Old Mill Lane is a roof for?
I'm trying to change that off.
You know what Bear Road is?
Yeah, parallel to Bear.
Going to
Okay.
It's the next road.
Okay.
And that bridge, is it anything beyond that?
Yeah, 2 or 3 houses.
Oh, okay, all right. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it serves 2 houses, and I think the bridge went in about 6 years ago.
Okay.
Maybe a little less, 5 years ago.
Thank you.
Is the state planning to provide any funding for this, or is this all on us? Do we know?
I don't think anyone knows.
The short answer is it's on us. The long answer is if there's time, somebody can research options and work with the state, mm-hmm. which requires engineering and time, and possibly, but even at that, state funding is 10 years out, so you have to get on the list and hope they accept you and wait. So that's kind of inconclusive.
If that's the case, I wonder if we should at least get on the list.
Well, yes, and I don't know, Suzanne knows better what the status of that is, because it's not been completely ignored, but, you know.
Yeah, I remember we talked about it before, but, you know, at least get on the list, because these things have a habit of, you know, we put the bridge in.
But applying doesn't mean you get on the list, you know.
Well, I believe it's still on the state's list.
It is, it's on the red listed bridge list, so.
Right. But But it's scheduled like 2027, and we don't start contributing in there until 2024. Mm-hmm. So I think probably the 27 might have been the cutoff of where this new bridge may be.
Possibly. And it depends what we do with it, because there are thoughts that perhaps we can make a temporary bridge temporary for longer rather than rebuilding a whole fancy new structure.
Mm-hmm.
So the lifespan, I think, depends on, if there are short-term remediations that we need to do sooner, or if,
Like somebody is working on that or looking at that?
I'm not sure I would say that.
I don't think it's active.
I think it's, Suzanne can, give a status and then.
Might be some other options.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I certainly think that's something we should be looking at it for someone, because that's the whole process of the whole thing. Is this what you have to do?
I'll see if I can find information and talk to Suzanne, and then I'll email the group about what the status and projections are. I agree.
Yeah, I think that might be what we considered was our share. So, do you know Fire Chief Mark Rutherford? Just walked in.
Brent Rowitz.
Mark Rutherford. And Kevin Herr, the
assistant
fire chief. So we can definitely follow up on that. But like I said, we're not going to start to. The plan is, we're usually trying to do like a 10 to a 15-year plan and starting putting money away so it doesn't all hit us with a big capital item. So these are the things that we have come up with. Also, on the capital plan, things can get changed on the priority. So the money is, you can option to kind of move it around if something more important steps up.
Right.
So it's really only a planning document. It's not a definite, this is what's going to happen in this year.
Yeah, it's just a working document to be adjusted.
Exactly. And then, with each department, they're going to say our priorities have changed or something like this. So they can shuffle that around.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So that's the.
The same one we did this time.
Yes.
Yes, it is. And the next one is the town administration police facility. This is something that's going to go forward this year. We're going to have a public hearing on July 31st. There is going to be two plans presented. One of them is just a police facility, and the other one is a police and town administration facility. And the proposed plan is to have it built on Silver Street in the empty lot there, where the old town shed was. That's all been taken down and everything's been removed. So that's what the plan is. Hopefully everyone can go and attend the public hearing, because each, we've brought it down to two manufacturers, and they're going to both present their plan. One at 6 and one at 7 or something like that. But there'll be announcements.
The date's been set for that?
It is the 31st of July.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We talked about it at town meeting. I mean, at the select board meeting Monday, Bob thinks it's fine just to have it here.
Yeah,
because we had talked about the school or even the Legion. Just don't think it's going to, if we have to take tables away and just use chairs, I think we could put enough people here. And the nice part is that we have this display thing that they can use to put their presentation up. So I believe we're going to try to have it here. So that is. 2025 is not, that hasn't been adjusted. They are looking to do request for it next year. And then renovate the third floor of the town hall. That's just kind of a staple item that has been out there. There isn't any plan for renovation. Last I knew, that only thing would happen on renovation of the third floor is donations to do something. So it's on there just because there's people are interested, but no money's coming forward to do it. And I don't think we can put town money for it. So that's what the town government side of it is. The police station, the vehicle replacement, Chief Duchamp is proposing that next year. The police get vehicles every one vehicle every other year. And due to high mileage on the cruises that we have right now, he's proposing to do a lease for 2 vehicles next year because of the high mileage. And so by doing that, he was doing 19 at 30,000, and I don't know if you want to change that, 19, and then 2020 at 20,000 and 2021 at 20,000 instead of the numbers that were listed there. This was the result of our last meeting.
Can you repeat the numbers where?
Okay, on vehicle replacement with equipment, 30,000 instead of 25 on 2019, 20,000 on 2020, and 20,000 on 2021. Okay?
I know he's not here, but is there a reason that we have higher mileage?
Yes.
Than anticipated?
We skipped a year of replacing a vehicle because of an accident.
Right, we had lost.
Okay.
Yeah. It's.
So we just kept, we kept one in service
longer.
Making more
mm-hmm.
trips, yeah. Thank you.
So, let me see what else. Also, we can get copies of this for the ones who weren't here, at Town Hall and PD long-term repairs. As we've mentioned before, the furnace. The generator had major issues with the police department, and the dollar, they had to repair them because they totally shut down. So they did repair them. I don't know how much, you know how much that was to repair what they, the generator. Okay, so we can get that for you. They also need HVAC condensers for $25,000 and upgrade security for $15,000. That's if they stay here in the building,
mm-hmm.
not if they decide to move.
So if we move from here and let's say that Southern Street, the
mm-hmm.
whole complex, the police, what's going to happen to this building?
Well, that hasn't been discussed yet on the town, on the Board of Selectmen side yet.
Okay.
I mean, clearly we've got to come up with a plan for that as well.
Yeah.
You know, what are we going to do with it?
Yeah, we're going to dump a bunch of money into it. What's the future outlook of the building? Is it going to sit here empty for the next 5 years after everybody moves?
Yeah, but that is definitely something that a decision has to be made before this can even go forward after the public hearing of just what it's going to cost for the new police station or town administration building. So,
one possibility is actually selling this building.
Yeah.
Right.
So, I mean,
yeah,
right.
Yeah.
I mean, everything's going to be on the table, I assume.
And I don't mean to be negative or to be gloomy, but there's a serious faction of people in town who value it. It's on the historic
mm-hmm.
registry. So it may not be that it will have to pass town meeting vote to build something, and it may not pass just because of that. We may be in purgatory. So please be special purgatory.
Stop in the basement.
or something. It you know, we'll propose whatever is proposed, but
we'll see. Yeah.
It's not going to be an easy decision what to do with this or to move at all.
Because
mm-hmm.
it has. I mean, there's not just what was listed here, but they have water issues downstairs. Laura Buckling. I just wish the chief was here, but
yeah.
You know, we certainly can have him write out something for you too, just so you stay on top of what has already been discussed.
Yeah, I've seen the videos and stuff online. I mean, the goal seems to get them out of there and get them somewhere so they can actually have a functioning place.
That's correct.
And then, that's the main goal, and then try not to lose too much money in the building after the fact.
Well, we originally were only doing for the police station. Then we had our police station meeting and the committee that was working with the chief on it. And it was decided that, you know, then if you just have a police, then this whole building is for like 6 or 7 people, which
mm-hmm.
didn't make a whole lot of sense.
Yeah.
So also because the police station, proposed police station is also having a very large conference room that isn't inside the police station and will be able to be used by any town group that needed to use it, as long as you notify the police department. So it's outside of the police station in the same building, but
mm-hmm.
able to be accessed from a private door, and then not being able to have to have a police person to let you in.
Yep.
So when we start talking about that, it's like, okay, well, let's do 2 proposals, see what the town says, and let them decide what to bring forward. Get there before anything.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Also, he was looking for a radar messenger board, a mobile sign. 50% would be coming from a grant, and that he's looking, I don't know, did he say what he was going to do in 2019? Did he say it? I don't remember. No.
That's where the money is.
Yeah, yeah. That might change, though, depending on the police department's projected on the police department, and also the digital printing system for 2020. So that's all he had, except for, of course, a new police station.
So is that price in 2019 to 23, is that the 50% out of the 100, or is that 100% and they're going to do 50 of that?
I believe the 2380 is ours.
Okay.
Yeah.
For those that weren't in attendance the last time, here is a list.
Thank you.
That's
nice paper.
Wow. That's
good.
I appreciate it. I think it's a nice paper.
Basically, what we've done from what we see in front of us is we reallocated our priorities. As we look at the list, of course, the fire engine replacement, we discussed that a little bit at the last meeting, obviously zero, because we have a new engine, which has been godsend for us, for the community, for the fire department, performing very well. So the next one down would have been the air filling station, and then radios, we flip-flopped them. Normally what we do is we have one portable radio assigned to each position on all of our apparatus. So basically every firefighter on every call has his own radio so that he can communicate for multiple reasons. Communication part of it, but they also have alert systems on them so if he's in trouble and has declared mayday, he can do that. So that's one reason we have to have the radio. So we move those up to our number one priority. Our second is our forestry truck. It's an 03. It's got a lot of issues. We managed to keep it taped together, keep it going, because it's not only forestry. We use it around the fire station for plowing. We run it on calls, especially in the wintertime with the plow, so we go to medical aids and whatnot. People have been able to open up their driveways. We do that. So it's an important piece for that. The other issue with that rig is that it's only a two-person vehicle. And the way service and our local response area, they're going to what they call strike team assemblies now, and our is on half a dozen or a dozen different strike teams, whether it be an engine, the tank truck, the forestry, and in order for the forestry to go, because basically what that plan is, instead of taking all the local apparatus, if there's a forest fire in Ossipee, they won't take all the mutual aid right from Ossipee, they're going to call from a strike team, which may come from the seacoast, or which may come from the area, so that they can keep the local people somewhat stocked and bring them from someplace else that's not stripped yet. So we're on a lot of those, and in the last few years they've hit some multiple listings that they would have started using them. There was a fire in Barrington 3 weeks ago now where they started using the tanker strike team because that system is now starting to be more widely used. It's only been in place for a couple of years, but it's starting to be used. And as I said, our forestry can only carry two. Requirement for the standard, which has been set up, you got to have four people on the force. But we don't care too. So that's another reason why we have the command vehicle. So if we got called to, again, Ossipee.
So then you wouldn't have to send a second vehicle?
Nope, and that's the goal, so we don't have to do that. I don't wanna send the other vehicle out of town, we don't have to, but as of now, we need to meet the standard which we've agreed to. We do that now on a common basis anyway. You know, we send a company over there, and we send an engine over three, we'll augment it in a vehicle. Or I'll take it over, so it's getting used a lot, it's been another asset, so it's got that. And then, because the air filling station was our.
Can I ask a question about?
Sure, can.
Forestry, I didn't know that you got rid of the forestry with the Harry God, so I was like thinking that forestry. So are you talking about a four-door pickup truck, and then you're gonna tank inside that pickup truck?
Yep, the unit that's in back now would just slide right.
It slides back, yeah, on and off, right?
New one.
Okay, so if a new, it would be a four-wheel drive probably, clearly, so that 50,000, that's about right for a pickup truck on a four-door. Okay, not really a forestry as much as it is a pickup.
No, it's a pickup truck, but we will be using it.
With a forestry unit on it.
Yeah, the main focus of what the vehicle's use will be for forestry.
Yeah.
For calls and responses, but again, we use that for all kinds of different things when we're out and about. And we wanna plow on it because we need to take care of the fire station, so that's the other reason.
But this is a much cheaper price than if you actually bought a forestry truck, correct?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's.
By far.
By far.
Well, I mean, I had a discussion with George because he has his new utility vehicle, and has all the cabinetry on the side. So it's kinda like, he's not looking very good for a forestry type unit, a crew cab with that kind of compartmentalization would be great. Because normally we just have one of those boxes that's in the back that you flip up, and it's just tough to get to it.
Yep.
When you put chainsaws in it or associated gear, you gotta climb up over something and get into it, and it's just not the most user-friendly method. But the thing that George has going with his in the compartment, we had a discussion on cost and stuff like that, so that's something, if this comes to fruition, that we may look into. But if nothing else, at least a, you know, four-person crew cab kind of.
Right, so would his truck actually be able to have that slider thing put in as well? It doesn't prevent, it still has a full bed?
You would buy the truck and you have that rear end kind of manufactured for what it needs, so you can make sure it could fit in.
Oh, okay.
What are we looking at, like a 250, 350, 40?
250.
250 would do it?
Yeah, like that.
I think we've been off the 350.
Ah, you're gonna say that.
Well, because.
I would.
We've had to.
Bigger the better, yeah, we can have that.
You can do it, you can do it with that.
Could handle the weight.
Yeah, the heavy duty end of it.
Yeah.
I agree. Somewhere in that line, you know, that kind of thing.
Single wheels though.
Oh, yeah, 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 definitely, no duals, none of that stuff.
Anybody else have any questions on the forestry?
And then, again, just kind of things kind of slid back down, the air filling station, and then the other things fill in. The one thing that's on that list that we have not had, and we had a discussion at the last time, and it will be added when we sit down and go through this issue in the future, and if you wanna write it on there just for your own, is start to fill in and add the replacement for engine one. Engine one right now is 17 years old, and we're starting to run into that problem again. We all know what went on with trying to get the engine that we have now, as it went into 30 years, we start having the issue. So we're looking at, as we run all the way, run this all the way out, somewhere around the year 2025, looking for a replacement for engine one. So that's 8 years down the road, and then we're looking at 25 years old at that point. And if it happens, then great, if not, it might give us a little buffer till we reach that. 25 is way beyond the expected life anyway, most fire engines only have a 20-year lifespan. We got 30 out of our last one, but that was only because after the 10-year mark, we put $70,000 into it, refurbed it, made it look pretty. Like I said before, if you flip it upside down, it's still a 30-year-old fire truck, that's where the issues are coming from. So when we get to that, we make it the 25-year mark, again, we're on borrowed time, so. It's not on here, but that will be added the next time.
Add it on here.
So would you say 550, 600, like, what's a filler price for that?
Yeah, go for 600.
I'm not, you know.
Easy.
I'm just saying, for what we paid this past year, and it's like, we're still.
We paid 450 for what we got with the truck.
And that's 6 years out.
Yeah, and a lot of the, and there were still needed funds that came out of the operational budget within the fire department to out-equip it. To equip it with the radios and stuff that we needed, that was not in that, even with the grant money that we received. So if we're looking 8 years out, and we're at 450, 600, it may not even be enough, but it would be a good ballpark figure to start.
Well, it's a starting point, then when we get closer, we can adjust it accordingly as well, yeah.
Yeah, I would say, you know, you'd probably make that fit into that. mean, for the piece that we have now, the replacement engine right now, we get a lot of bang for our buck on that truck. Because it's a very, very good piece of equipment that we can use.
And then down the road, we would be looking to replace the one we just bought now in 35?
It's a 2018.
18?
So it'd be 28, 38, 2040. Yeah, easily.
Somebody else's problem.
It's hard enough on the next 10 years.
You still gonna be on the committee? You still gonna be on the committee?
I don't think I'll be on any committee, but I'm not sure we're on the committee.
So that was the only other thing, and again, you know, like I said, things just kind of came down, some of those things on our list that they just bounce around, but the priorities again changed with us. What we were looking at here, if you look down here, it says the money that's in reserve already for, on the fire department side of things, we had a discussion on that, and it said there was $40,000 already. And that was gonna go towards the air filling station, but the radios just blew that right out of the water, came right in.
So you're gonna get six radios, is that what that gives you?
Pretty much, yeah.
Is that enough?
No. It's not.
You need to do this again?
We need 25 radios.
25. The ones you're replacing, the ones you're replacing, are they the ones that are basically gone, or are they all gone?
No, they're basically gonna, basically our plan is gonna be, if we get these ones here, we'll be assigning them to the first two pieces, which is engine two. So that would have all the newer equipment, and I would have one of those, Kevin would have one of those. And then as we augment it on a yearly basis, then we would be putting it in the apparatus as they go. I mean, the ones we have now, they work.
Yeah.
I mean, they've got a little bit of a strain on them with this Dover switch over to digital.
Right.
Because these radios aren't totally designed to handle that load, it's only one channel, so it's okay. But, like I said, we've had two fail already that are sitting on the desk, and I imagine that pile will be getting bigger.
What about grants?
We've looked into grants 2 years running.
Just nothing out there yet?
No, they're out there.
Oh, they're out there.
It's just, we've made our way further up the list.
We do so well qualified.
We're almost there, you know, we've had some, we've been using a lot of Summersworth influence, because they have a very good grant writer over there. And one of our members is a Summersworth firefighter.
Excellent.
So this last time, we made it up into the top echelon of getting it, so maybe next year we break through that door and get our grant. But we're on top of that every single year, we're out there looking for our grant.
I know you usually are, I just wanted to check, because I didn't even know if there was money out there, but there is, you just have to get it.
There is.
Chief, when you buy these radios, is it, is the deal such that if you had extra money, not that anybody ever does, but in an operational account, that you could take $2,500 and buy another radio, or $3,000?
I could buy it for unit, per unit.
Okay, so you don't have to buy 10 all at once.
Right, and you look at the budget, there's $8,000 sitting in there. We need radios, so.
Okay.
We could go out and grab one radio.
And also, we had talked about increasing his radio budget as well, to probably to compensate and getting some more within his operating budget.
We could do that operation as well.
You know, so, because they're, I mean, they're in such bad shape that it would be replacing as he can.
And this is the state radio that you can flip channels, if you guys could send it over to Keene or up to Colebrook, they can, they all work, right, allegedly?
We had channels in there for about every frequency within the state, on the fire end and the police end.
Right.
It's got like 200 channels in here, because the radios within the, we replaced the one in engine one when we had a grant money, well, not grant money, but operational money a couple of years ago, and we did the same thing, the top of the line.
Yeah.
And the command vehicle in both ends, top of the line radios right now.
Can anybody just figure out how to use them, because I never could, there's more channels than you.
I'll tell you, we went to Barrington, yeah, we went to Barrington the other day, it's got eight different zones, and each zone has 50 channels in it. So we're on our way to Barrington, and I'm, all right, it's not in A, it's not in B, it's not in C, we're trying to find Barrington, and just before we arrive, okay, I got Barrington's channel, I start calling. No, they're not on that, they're on the fire ground frequency channel, so after all that switching and then, okay, fire ground's in A bank, so click, 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 we're right there, we're gonna go, so. But I was clicking through a lot of channels, it's like, wow, we go there, at least I know we can talk to somebody.
And the radio comes all programmed with everything in it, right, all those channels are all in there?
We have the capability to do what we need, we have a member within the fire department. Again, a kickoff on this Dover thing, is when all this happened, we had Two-Way doing a lot of the work for us, and Two-Way was not very friendly or efficient. They drop the ball on a lot of things. So one of our members is very, very good at radio. And we've taken some of the money from within our operational budget. And he has bought some of the equipment he needs, he can program some stuff. Even our pagers. Because when this happened, it wasn't just radios we had to worry about, we had to worry about pagers. And the pagers is what alerts everybody. And they were basically, they were no good until we got them reprogrammed. We also found out about 15 of them were no good because they couldn't be reprogrammed because they were too old. One of them was mine, it sits on my nightstand at night, it was waking me up. So we had to catch up with all that, and he does those. Because we'd send them down there, and they wanted like $80 a unit.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, I can buy a cable and buy his little port, his little docking station for like $60 and do the same thing. And he does all of them. So just by... Yeah, George, if you need something, I mean, I got a radio that he's getting the cable.
Yeah, I want to be programmed some of the radio.
Just come on over, and all he needs to do is get some information. He may have to, you know, buy a cable or docking thing, but he can do it. And he constantly updates stuff like any of us.
That's awesome.
So there's another asset he can use. It's AJ.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's great.
Yeah. So that's a kind of win-win for us. Find a way of having
much, much better solution.
Depend on everybody else. Yeah, do our own thing.
Is there a life expectancy on the radios? I understand it's technology and stuff. The last set of radios lasted about 20 years.
There you are.
I'm just curious. I mean,
do you have a smartphone?
Yes, unfortunately.
Good for 5 years.
So how long does that go until you need another one? It's a great question.
Yeah.
And as technology advances, the same thing. But if we get these radios, we're going to get 20.
And you just run them until they die, and then we're back to the same thing again.
Pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah, pretty much. Again, you can reprogram them. You can do a lot of different things with them. But you get a good 20 years out of these radios, no doubt. And again, that's our number one priority, because we're facing issues.
Good stuff. All right, any other questions for the fire department? Anything else you want to say? No.
I covered all mine.
Okay.
I added a little bit to it.
Tom, you want to add a new station on?
we'll put that replacement engine on as well. Okay.
Only things I can achieve.
Highway department.
I just wanted to change one priority, and I'm looking for a new sidewalk machine, something that fits on our sidewalks. And I have a quote for about $80,000 for one that we'll replace what we have, the skid steer, which we're not going to get rid of. We want to keep that at the transfer station. Our sidewalks are 5 feet wide. The sidewalk machine is 5.5 feet wide, so 90% of our sidewalks are not getting done. We get the main roads done, and as much as we can on the others, because we're either digging up lawns or pulling off the sidewalks and what have you. The new machine is going to be 4 feet wide, so if we have to take a second pass, that's not an issue. And it's actually a machine that can be used all year round. And every attachment we have for our skid steer will actually work with this articulating, it's a small articulating loader, if anyone's interested in taking a look at it.
That's not on here yet. That's an addition?
That's an addition. We're going to
make that number one.
That would make that number one.
It was an add-on at the meeting.
Wacker Newson is a company that makes it. Some of the housing authority has one, and if it's only a sidewalk behind all their properties, and actually, it's a dime versatile machine. You can actually put a sander on it, so we can also treat our sidewalks besides.
So you get a bucket on it?
A bucket. That'll actually fill a big truck.
And then you put
the bucket comes with it. The snow blower, it would be an option. We're going to buy it. We need a narrower one. Ours is too big. And the sander will be an option to buy. The rest of the attachments that we have for our skid steer, like the forks or anything like that, we're not going to have to spend the money on it. It's an articulating machine, and it goes over the road a lot better than skid steer too, so we won't. It'll also relieve the usage of running a big backhoe down the road and stuff like that. We could use that for a lot more, things in town. The versatility of that machine versus the skid steer has got it all over it. Even the roadside. carries it here, and there's also Jordan Equipment in Maine that carries it for the Maine side. They actually, we have a, our compact is made by the same company, Weckenhusen. But they're all foreign equipment when you're going to start getting into, you know, the smaller stuff. However, if you decided to buy a regular sidewalk specific machine, you can actually double the price. And it's not used for everything. I think if we're going to buy something, we can have it, we can use it for multiple things. Maybe a thought down the road is to buy a smaller sweeper for the sidewalks and stuff we can use, and, you know, we can use it for other things too, but that doesn't have to happen if it went, right now.
What was the cost on that? I'm sorry.
Total price,
$80,000
right now is where we're at.
What was your expectation year? I didn't write that down.
Excuse me?
What was your expectation year of getting this?
For this?
Mm-hmm. For that?
I would hope to be able to buy it in this, on the next, this coming
2019.
And you and I talked about a lease option.
Right. That's, there's other options. So we could lease it or lease purchase it. I mean, I didn't get the figures for that because I know leasing rate was not a talkable item at one point. So, but I mean, we can look into that. I know some of the housing authorities lease purchased it. I think they lease it for two, I think it's 2 or 3 years, and then they pay $1 they want.
Mm-hmm. That's just like cruises, right? I mean, that's what they were talking about too.
But I mean, that's, if they want to continue to do sidewalks the way we're doing it, I mean, that's fine. But I believe if we have sidewalks, we should be maintaining.
Okay.
And the dump truck that was on this list that we put off from last year because it was on last year's list is still functionable. I think we can get another year out of it.
That's
the
GMC tough kit.
The GMC
right?
tough kit.
So you're thinking 2020?
Yeah. And that 190 is not the.
You said 160
yeah.
at the last meeting?
We just saw a demo at the. New Hampshire Municipal Association show, and the truck size that we need is running around 100 and a half instead of the 190. The 190 would be for a full size big dump truck, which most of our streets we can't plow that big truck. So.
And so the utility truck is what you got last year, so
that's,
that comes off.
That doesn't go anywhere.
Yeah.
The skid steer will not be, we own it. I don't think we need to replace it. Worry about replacing that. Sell the machine to take care of that function. And down the road, if it becomes an issue where we need to skid steer more at the transfer station, we can look into it then.
Is that the skid loader? So that you're saying that can come off?
If you get other things.
If you get
if we replace
that
yeah. sidewalk machine, we're not going to replace it. We still own it.
Yeah.
But we're going to keep it.
Okay.
We're not going to trade it.
Okay.
But that will be specific to the transfer station after.
Okay.
We'll move that into a transfer station account.
Okay.
And right now there's nothing else on the CIP.
What is this, the International 7400 dump truck and plow?
That was purchased in 2013.
Okay, but now it's still on there.
Put reference down the road.
To put money aside for
2025?
Yeah.
This is what it's saying.
Yeah.
So that's staying on, not coming off, right?
You don't want to be taking that off, no.
And then you're 4 to 550 for 2026.
Mm-hmm.
And then the boiler 2027.
Right. That was on the schedule for last year. And the building was 9 years old. And
but you said
you
said you got something fixed and that now it's working fine, right? Okay.
Yeah, it was working fine when I took over.
And then the backhoe replacement in 2027.
Yep.
And then the roof in 2024. So those are all staying on there. Just
sure. Down the road.
The priority of the one and two
you know,
change.
Yeah, right.
Yep.
I mean,
okay.
These have been moved a few times, and
yep.
we'll probably get moved again.
All right. And what about your transfer station?
Hold on. Nothing on there this year for the transfer station. However,
that may change
drastically soon. transfer station, streamline recycling is gone down the tubes. To make any money recycling, we need to go back to sorting and compact, and baling. So if we're gonna do that, we're gonna need a baler.
And that's for aluminum?
Aluminum, plastic, tin cans, there's a market for all these things.
So we're baling a variety of things.
This group, yes. What our thought is at our transfer station right now, we have dumpsters for streamline recycling and a demo dumpster along the wall. We're talking about taking and making bins there, and all that is gonna be making bins is, what we have to make bins is Jersey barriers. We're gonna just dump the glass and stuff, those glass or tin cans and stuff off the wall the same way it was, and we'll use our skid steer to load the compactor. But once those bins are full, we'll know that that's a bale. So we can bale it individually. We can stack those types of bales outside. They don't need no coverage for metal or glass or anything like that. Glass we can haul with our truck up to Wakefield, as we have a truck load. They recycle it up there, and that's including your toilets and stuff that's going in the demo dumpsters now that we're paying good weight on, that we don't need to be paying on. Anything glass will be able to go in the glass side of it.
And that includes like crockery or
across, anything that's made with
glass. Ceramics.
Okay,
cardboard stays gonna stay the same, and we may start bailing new paper. Office paper and newspapers.
Mm-hmm. And you can bail that as well.
That can be bailed also.
So what will you do with all the bins that we have that we're doing now to streamline? We bought those, right?
We own all of our containers.
Okay, so what would you do with those?
Maybe they'll take some and trade for a compact
for a
bailer. We don't know yet.
Well, we'd give them the worst one, right? Just saying. Keep the good ones.
Right now, we're having, of course, we had to change trucking companies because of the Lamprey situation.
Do you anticipate being able to do this with your present staff, or are you going to need, at least temporarily, some additional help to guide people? Because I imagine during the changeover, it's going to be a bit hectic.
Or increase the hours.
Yeah.
We're going to get increased hours for the guys.
At least
we are using the guys now to do tripping and stuff. We've added some hours for that.
Yeah.
But I think we may have to add some. One, maybe.
Yeah.
You know, but we got to be paying attention more to what's going on, for sure, without a doubt.
Yeah, because you almost need somebody to, I would think, supervise who's dumping what where.
In what bins.
In what bins.
Yeah. I agree.
So
we had a meeting recently and learned a lot about how we can and should be doing this better, so that we can save a lot of money, but we're going to have to spend money to save money.
Right.
And the spend money is the company.
Is the baler, yes.
The baler.
Yeah.
We have one in mind. They have one. They used one for already for us. If you're getting prices for us, we'll have by the end of the week. However, I don't know if that's going to end up in the CIP, but we're going to have a plan in the future.
Can you venture or should a ballpark for what we're looking at for the baler?
Right now?
Yeah.
About 20 grand.
And if we don't, it's going to make more sense for things to go in the trash.
Or we can spend 80 grand and get a fancy baler with the chutes and everything like that that drags everything into it.
Yeah. But
we're not, for 2,500 people, it's not worth spending that money.
Yeah. But you think for 20 grand you can get a device that will suffice? Because quite honestly, I mean, depending on the market, this all could change again in a year.
Absolutely.
But it will continue to favor
separating
things.
Yeah.
It will continue to change, but it will always continue to favor separating things.
What
and the baling the plastic and tin cans and all these other things will allow us to maximize haul charges.
Yeah, I was going to say, we're going to save money in hauling.
So
yeah.
There is money to be saved.
Mm-hmm.
Do we need to separate plastics by 1, 2, 3, 4, or is that all?
Right now we're talking about baling all our plastics together.
All plastics. Okay.
There is a market out there for that. There is a market for separating them further. And that's, again, right now we're just trying to get things back.
Yeah. So you could just do plastics now and then down the road.
Sort.
Sort.
Sort them, yeah.
Yeah, we can make a few more bins and just sort them that way. Again, this is gonna be training.
Yeah.
Control, so you gotta have control of that.
And there are a lot of small changes that we learned that we can make already that will make a difference in how we're doing things that don't really impact the public. So that's good, but it's about staying on top of the markets and continuing to pay attention to what's going on, so we can continue.
We may be shipping to Massachusetts.
Yeah.
You know, but it's where the dollar value is.
Yeah. And I realize this might be a little off our subject here, but is there an educational component that we need to get for the public?
Yes.
Or
now, let's remember, we've only been single stream for 2 years, people. I embraced it tremendously, but I think I remember how to separate.
Well,
I mean, it's like, I'm sorry, but it's been 2 years.
But I think we're still gonna need.
Well, you're right.
Yes, but we have to, the board has to decide what's gonna happen, and then that will happen.
I'm anticipating my Saturday trip to the dump. Things are gonna be different, right?
Well, yes. Well,
without a doubt, things are gonna be different.
Yes.
And.
Even with today's email, today or yesterday's email that came out, I said, well, do I have to start separating? Or, you know, I have to find my containers.
That's just about pay attention, like traffic patterns change ahead, you know.
I'm ready to do what has to be done.
And I agree that separation, I think, is the way to go.
We found out a lot of stuff. I mean, just the fact that we can have our freon removed from the refrigerator's air and claim, and take the steel ourselves instead of sending the units out and them making the money on it.
Oh, it's huge. Even that alone is huge.
It's great.
Propane tanks?
Good stuff.
All we have to do is devalve them?
Oh.
And then it's scrap metal?
Then it's become scrap metal.
Instead of disposing of it, we can earn a little bit of money on it.
And cutting cords up, I saw something.
Cut your electric cords off anything that comes in, those appliances, put them in a 55-gallon drum, that's copper.
And they'll take it. There's a market.
Fascinating stuff.
Are we getting ahead of the curve, or compared to the others, I don't know if anybody has this.
I think we're moderate. There's certainly people that are way more ahead of the game than we are, but the point is to act now, because the single stream is tanking quickly.
Yeah,
so as bad as it is, it's gonna get way worse.
Oh yeah, this is national, this isn't our problem, this is national.
International, right?
Yeah.
I mean, single stream is twice what we could pay for dumping in some places right now.
Excellent.
It'd be cheaper to throw our stuff in the trash.
Now, if you take the freon all out of that stuff, do you need to buy equipment for that too?
No, it's not us doing it. The company's gonna come in and take the freon, and mark the refrigerators as clean.
Processed.
And they're gonna charge us for that though?
They'll charge for the freon?
They'll charge us, but less than what it would cost to have the unit taken away, which was what used to happen. Plus, we're keeping it for scrap metal, and we earn money on scrap metal.
Yeah, okay. I'm just curious, because they take the freon out, are they going to recycle and resell it? They're making a double.
Probably, yes.
But we were paying, they were hauling it off.
Yep, and charging us more.
And charging more.
Okay.
And then you weren't getting the scrap out of it. They were. So they were making double either way.
Mm-hmm.
We manufactured a valve remover today at the shore out of a piece of pipe So we removed all the belts and the tanks that we have, and now we got a pile of scrap that's been sitting around for years.
Yep.
It was 50, 60 tanks sitting over there, not being done. So I looked online and said, yeah, that's easy, we can do that. So we just, we took care of, taking all the belts out so we get some steel money.
It's R410.
And the microwaves and stuff, all they have to do is cut the cords, and if there's the old resistors or whatever they used to be in, that has to be taken out. That goes to scrap now, instead of having to send it like your computers. And your towers and laptops, there's a market for that stuff.
Yeah. And we can put microwaves with a little bit of time and processing in-house. We can put microwaves in the scrap metal piles. Yeah, I'm sorry, I missed that. So lots of little things we can do.
And there's more ideas all the time, people coming up with, so.
That's great.
Good stuff.
One thing we don't have a place for yet is wood chips, but we will, find something, hopefully.
So, are you planning on putting a baler in the transfer station, under the transfer station for CFP?
I'm just saying, future.
But that might be a very near future.
Which means, you're going to do it now, or we're going to start throwing away.
So you're
now
saying budget, not.
It's going to have to be.
I mean, find money now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
$20,000 is going to have to be found, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, we're throwing away and then we're recreating, you know,
sorting. Put a compact on the list for future.
But what about, would it be feasible to have more than one baler?
This is going to give us our second baler.
Oh, you already have a baler?
We have a padwood baler now.
Oh, okay.
But that will
not stop the one that's broken.
Will that work for
no,
this?
No, it's not.
It's not. This one here is going to be a bigger horizontal type compact, but we can get more density and you get better bales. The cardboard bale will stay the same and we may be able to pay for the cardboard.
So right now, if we switch over to this new system that we're going to start on Saturday, we're going to be...
No, don't think Saturday.
At some point, so we can't do anything until we get this bale.
That's exactly it.
Well, we can do glass, and we can do, like, you know, the Freon and the tires and the,
right.
You know.
Right.
We can do some little things, but the whole sorting thing, aside from glass, can't
be
without
bailing.
Okay. Wait till
you
get the bailing. Right.
Or if
it's...
If they decide they want to buy a bailer, we can start separating. We can fill them in.
Yeah.
And
we can do glass anyway.
Right. Well, we've got to set the place up, but we've got to get these other dumpsters out of the way.
All right, so you don't need to be planning for another bale or anything at this point in time.
We can start with the used
equipment.
It's going to be refurbished and everything.
And you mentioned wood chips. We have wood chips that we can't get rid of?
Wood chips are available to the public if they want them.
Okay.
We're chipping our own brush right now.
Mm-hmm. So there's a pile down there?
There's a pile there if you wanted to.
Yeah.
Yep, you want wood chips, plenty there.
But then there's too much that we need to get rid of.
What was happening before that... Company would come in and chip the wood, chip our branches up and haul all our stuff away. And we're spending $2,500 a year. Well, we already own a chipper. We get guys that are willing to come in a few days a week, you know, chip it ourselves, and all we do is find a place to get rid of it after we offer it to the public or whatever.
Okay.
You just
have
to pay the cost of labor.
Not going to be, they're only working a couple hours a day, you know, a couple hours a week to chip it and stuff like that. Now because we get a little bit behind, but, you know, you guys are going to be a little bit busier at the transfer station because these things are going to have to happen. They're going to have to devalve the tanks and stuff like that, but, you know, and cut the cords off when they come in. But again, it's going to have to be trained, you know, people are going to have to be trained and stop when you come in and let them tell you where to go. Instead of just driving up to a dumpster and dumping your demo, that's all stuff you make money on.
All right, any other questions for the highway department? All right, school?
Yes, I apologize. I didn't bring a handout, but I thought nothing's really changed, but I will make sure that there is a handout for the next time around. As many of you know, we've done a lot in the school where things are happening already. This summer, the warrant article, the pass on the roof, that work will be done this summer. But we do have some big items coming up. And these are items that go back to the 2013 IDEA study, things that we knew needed to be done, that were already behind being done. They were late being done. So the first thing on our list is a sort of a security issue, which was not in the IDEA study. That study, which many of you remember, did not address security at all. But one of the key things we've looked at now is getting a secure entrance to the building, as well as a handicapped accessible, an accessible entrance. We don't really have one. The front door, as some of you know, if you have kids there, you have to go up steps. And then another set of steps to get to the principal's office. We had plugged in a number on that. What we managed to do was find the money in our budget of last year to have a study done that will tell us more what the real cost would be. So before we even put it on a CIP or look with it, we're getting that. We'll know that in another month or so, what that will be. We had plugged in $300,000, but we really have no idea what the cost to do that. And then we sort of have it in our head. heads of having that done in like the 2020 timeframe. Ventilation is needed throughout the school. And again, we've just plugged in a figure for that, which is a big amount of money. It's $400,000.
That's an HVAC.
It's an HVAC system. Well, it's not HVAC because there's no cool. We have not considered cooling, just ventilation. That's not heating. It's ventilation. So the air exchangers, those. Next on the list, though, you're anticipating here, Bill, is.
What's your year?
Well, again, we were looking at the following year, so 2021. These follow right after each other, 2020, 2021, 2022, 2023. They're all obviously, some of them are things that we can work with. Some of you may remember that 4 or 5 years ago, we thought the boilers were all going to blow up and we were going to need a new heating system immediately throughout the school. With Dick Fortier coming on as our facilities director, he's been much the way George has come in and found things that he could make work and do things. Dick has done the same thing at the school, and he has kept those boilers working very efficiently. We have saved on fuel every single year, not just because the price has gone down, but because he has kept them working very efficiently. But by 2022, we're looking at those boilers are indeed reaching the very end of their lives. Again, we're looking at that happening there. And then the last bit on here, which are things that we are actually addressing piecemeal. Major items, but they're major items, replacing ceiling tiles throughout the school. Well, we've been doing some every year, so we're working on that. Plumbing throughout the school. We've been doing that piecemeal, within our operational budget. What we're not doing in plumbing at the moment is all the stuff behind the walls. We're doing the stuff in front of the walls. We're replacing sinks, replacing toilets, putting in the instant hot water kinds of things rather than running with water and those kinds of things. So at some point, we might have to get behind the walls a bit more and do some more replacement back there. And that was the last thing. So that's basically what's coming up. And we are getting, indeed, we're getting more information, so there will be a request for proposals on the, we'll start thinking about when we really want to do the, think about the reconfiguration for security and entry level, and sort of better use of space as well in the building. And also the retrofit of the main building, the original ventilation system. And again, when Dick Fortier came on, he discovered that one of the kitchen ventilation system had not been working for years. It was in reverse. And that would have gotten us closed down in an instant had anyone noticed that in her inspections. So he got that fixed and working like his first week on the job. That was fantastic. So those are the kind of, those, and that's it. That's the complete list of things that's coming down the line. After that, there's like a 10-year break before we have to think about a new roof for the main building.
Because you're doing the annex this
year,
right?
Doing the annex and kindergarten this year. Yep. Thanks to the warrant article that passed, that's happening.
Well, do you know what that cost to rent a ballpark for the boilers?
The ballpark is $400,000. And it's not just, now I want to make it clear, it's not just for the boilers. It's the entire heating system for the entire building.
And it's also $400,000.
That again, ballpark, and it's from a study from 2013. Those figures are coming from a study that was done in 2013.
And then for the security entrance, the ballpark was $300,000. Was that just somebody looking up, or where did we get that number from?
It probably came from when we were looking a couple of years ago about sort of upgrading the entire school and adding on some pieces. It probably came from that. And now we're not thinking of doing that, obviously. So we know we need to get more information as we move forward each year on each of these to get very specific. And the other thing I'll remind everybody of is we finally realized that our building reserve fund can be used like a CIP fund in essence, just to understand it better. We used to think it could only be used for emergencies, that we couldn't plan to put things in. And so now that we know we planned, we did, and again, thanks to the warrant article, we put $75,000 in this year. And our, you know, should we have those kinds of funds available going forward, we will continue to do that. So
that's when you have funds left over at the end of the year and you can move
that's
it.
How we've been, that's how we've been doing it
yeah.
up till now, and obviously we're going to try to continue to do as much of that as possible. There may come a time when we'll ask to put money in it, like a CIP fund. I mean, you really call it that. But so at the moment, we're up to about $180,000.
Do you need a warrant article to remove the funds
yes.
from there?
Yeah, yes, we do. So it's the same way we do with like a truck or something
yep.
here. So that's in general what's coming up. So if anyone has any questions.
Any questions for this tool? Okay, so I will have this updated and make sure that everyone gets a copy of it. And I will bring it to the board. And I don't know if we will have another meeting. I don't know if the heads of the board, if they need more information on yeah.
Can we, when you redo this, have the date reflect the current date? This is December 11, 2017. So I think it's just a matter of formatting on the sheet.
Yep.
So that way they know.
I can't scan anything that big.
So I don't know, but it's on the drive. So
yep.
talk to her about
how we can update
manage
it.
And yeah.
Yep.
Yeah,
version.
Yes.
And so
yep.
we know which
yes.
one
yes. Absolutely.
It's probably the last one.
Yes.
So we'll, yeah. So. Okay. Yep. We'll definitely look at that. And any other questions?
Okay. Thanks for. I'm happy to be a part of this. Thank you.
All right. So unless I am advised by the board that we need to have another meeting, I will just send it to you. But if you have any questions, feel free to call or email me, and I can do my best to get the answer to you. Okay. So we will make sure that those go out to you electronically. So that works for you guys electronically? Okay. Very good. All right.